In the name of Jesus, who gathers us in for this time of worship and praise, welcome to Westminster, an affirming ministry in the United Church of Canada. So good to have all of you with us here in person and online. I wish you could see.
You want me to turn it around?
We need to turn the camera around if you don't mind. I see some anyway. Boy, when I give an instruction. You folks look fantastic.
Oh, but come to that.
I said wear some red and green.
Stand next to the
field.
Yeah, oh, you're the boss.
Hey, look at the girl.
Oh, hang on a minute. Once more with feeling. Okay.
Yay.
The land on which we worship this morning is land that has been walked on, hunted on, and lived on for thousands of years. It is the traditional land of the Anishinaabe and the ancestral territory of the Fort William First Nation. We acknowledge with gratitude the good stewardship of this land from generation to generation, and we're grateful today for the beauty and abundance all around us. May we always remember the story of this land and our call to live upon it with respect, humility, and gratitude. Okay, once again, I have a few announcements, but we'll start with celebrations. And today is Donna Brown's birthday, so happy birthday to you, Donna. We all wish you the best for your special day. Other celebrations this morning. Pat.
Tuesday, Hannah's going to be 27.
Hannah's going to be 27 on Tuesday.
How's I don't know if some people remember when I was in the choir when he was a baby and he used to come call, run away from downstairs, come crawling up the stairs and sit and watch.
Yes,
he was little then.
That was just 3 years ago.
That's what all the cool kids want to be in the choir.
That's right. Okay, announcements. Bear with me, folks. Wednesday evening Advent prayer services have started, so Wednesday at 7 throughout Advent, we'll have an evening prayer service at 7 p.m. This service is online only, so don't come to the church. Next Sunday is Stocking Stuffer Sunday. I said that carefully. So next week, you can come and pick up all kinds of wonderful jams, jellies, and preserves to put in stockings for the season. Janine and her team will have everything set up on the table where the baskets are today, and you'll be all set for Christmas. So that's next Sunday. You can buy jams, jellies, and preserves, and all the proceeds will go to Westminster. Today is White Gift Sunday, of course, and thank you to everyone who's already got some food under here already. You can also give by check, made out to Christmas Cheer Fund, not to Westminster. And you can also donate online. If you just go to their website, Christmas Cheer Fund Bay, and go to the website, it's really easy to donate online if you prefer to do it that way. A reminder that our thermometer is up on the wall at the end of the basket table there if you want to take a look and see where we're at with our annual goal for givings. Apologies to everyone in the sanctuary who have experienced a very loud worship service in the past few weeks. We have, I think, fixed that. But yes, it was very loud, and we apologize. And snow shoveling, I think we're still looking for snow shovelers, or are we set?
We have some volunteers, but we'll always accept more. We're gonna leave Jim Bidnell alone for a few weeks. He's recovering from surgery, so I have the schedule. So see me if you feel like you can take on a week or two.
Okay, if you think you can take a week or so of snow shoveling, just talk to Kim. Did I miss any? Doesn't look like. Oh, sorry.
Basket.
Oh yes, of course. What's the big thing we're doing today? Baskets. Okay, so today is the final day of the basket auction. We have all our baskets lined up on the table over there. They're also online. So the bidding can continue through our worship service today, and we'll close
approximately 10 minutes after the end of service.
Roughly 10 minutes after the close of our worship service, the auction will close, and Jamie will announce when that happens so that the bidding stops at the table and online. Good luck to all of you.
Yeah, for online worshipers, just check the updates as we go. We're continually updating bids as they come in, so they have an option to bid online as well.
Okay. Online folks, the bids will be updated as we go along. Remarkable work over there, okay? Bids on paper and online, but it's all going to happen nice and seamlessly. So that will happen, and we'll close that off about 10 minutes after worship. Let's celebrate God's presence in our midst. Let's worship. Today we light the candle of peace.
Peace be quiet. It can also be many voices calling out for justice and reconciliation.
Peace on earth is a lofty but worthy goal for people of faith.
God honors our peace.
In this season of watching and waiting, we trust in God to light our way.
As we await the birth of the babe in a manger, God's peace surrounds us.
We also light this special candle to remember all the children who suffered and died in Indian residential schools.
No, it's not there.
No, I missed that.
No, I think I messed it up.
That's okay. So we light special candles all through the year, and especially in Advent, we light another one every week around the Christ candle. We light the candles of hope and peace and joy and love. And then we light the Christ candle on Christmas Eve. And I thought that because today is a special sort of day here at Westminster, I thought we might add another candle. And I thought we might call it the candle of fun. candle is wearing a funny Christmas sweater. Now, I know Advent is meant to be a time of quiet waiting and watching and contemplating the birth of Jesus. And it's important that we do that. But it's also really important that we have some fun along the way. So that's why we brightened our day with our candle of fun. Now, with gratitude, we receive these gifts for our local Christmas Cheer Fund, as it's our White Gift Sunday. And that's a day for giving. It's a day when we collect for people who are not as fortunate as we are and who are unable to provide around the time of Christmas. So for everyone who's donated food or money for the Christmas Cheer Fund this year, thank you. Thank you all. Let's have a short prayer and dedicate our givings to the Christmas Cheer Fund this year. Let's pray. Gracious God, we pray, bless these gifts that have been collected for people in our community. May they bring joy and meaning to the lives of those who will receive them. May the giving of these gifts remind us of the many ways in which we are interconnected with one another, regardless of our faith beliefs or our human circumstances. Holy One, may our gifts of food bring both nourishment and joy. Amen. Next week. Okay. I'm going to begin the scripture readings with a reading from the first chapter of Luke, what's known as Zechariah's song. Zechariah being the husband of Elizabeth. And we'll hear next week, about Elizabeth and Mary meeting together on a hillside. But for today, we hear Zechariah's song. He says, "Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has looked favorably on his people and redeemed them. He has raised up a mighty Savior for us in the house of his servant David. As he spoke through the mouth of his holy prophets from of old, that we would be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all who hate us. Thus he has shown the mercy promised to our ancestors and has remembered his holy covenant, the oath that he swore to our ancestor Abraham, to grant us that we, being rescued from the hands of our enemies, might serve him without fear, in holiness and righteousness before him all our days. And you, child, will be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his ways, to give knowledge for salvation to his people by the forgiveness of their sins. By the tender mercy of our God, the dawn from on high will break upon us to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace." Now I'm going to invite three very special readers up to share our gospel, another gospel reading this morning. And we have John as our town historian, Alexander as one town storyteller, and Abby as another storyteller. They're here to tell us about John the Baptist.
Tiberius Caesar had reigned for 15 years, and Pontius Pilate was governor of Judea. Herod was tetrarch of Galilee, and his Philip was tetrarch of Iturea and Trachonitis. Lysanias was tetrarch of Abilene. At this point, you may be wondering what a tetrarch is. Am I right? It's quite simple, really. A tetrarch under the Roman Empire was part of a team of four leaders in a particular geographical area. A country or province had four distinct sections, each led by a single governor. Each of those governors was known as a tetrarch. It's notable that this structure also assured that no single leader ever had as much power as the ruling power, Rome.
Anyway, it was during this time that the word of God came to John, the one who was the son of Zechariah. While he was out in the wilderness, John is known for his interesting fashion and dietary choices. He wore only a camel hair coat with a leather belt, and he ate locusts and honey. After this, John went to all the country around the Jordan River, preaching about making confessions and seeking forgiveness. He also baptized many people in the river. That's where he gets his name, John the Baptist, or John the Baptizer.
You do know that this was written in the book of Isaiah, the prophet.
We know that that's what makes it so incredible.
A voice called in the wilderness.
It came to John, the one who was the son of Zechariah.
Prepare the way for the Lord. Clear the path and make his way easy. Oh, I love this part. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill made low.
The crooked roads shall become straight, and the rough ways will be made smooth.
And all the people will see God's goodness.
And thus ends this part of the story of the man known as John the Baptist.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you so much to our historian and our two storytellers. Okay, at this point in our service, we have some activities. In the back corner, where the prayer shawls are, we've got a table set up, and the children, will, with Melissa's help, will be packing up the gift bags to go out to some of our friends here at Westminster. If you'd like to help at the table, by all means, do so. We will also need a few folks to deliver some of these bags after service today. So if you're able to do that, that would be wonderful. Just check the list on the table, and any empty spot, if you can fill that in, that would be great. We also have our basket auction, of course, happening on this side, and because the bids are closing fairly soon, you might want to get over there and see if you've been outbid on your favorite basket, and maybe even bid higher. Remember, all proceeds go to children within our church, so within our community and within our church. And also, Kim is going to lead us through some special Christmas music while all that is going on. The words will be on the screen, so I know that our online church will be singing along with us. And we'll gather back in about 10, 12 minutes, something like that. So, off you go.
Anticipating noise, I'm going to turn it up just a little bit. If it's too loud, give me one of these and I'll knock you back down.
They did it. Alexander did a great job. He was really nervous about it.
I just need to get in there.
Sorry. Let's try that again.
Thank you.
This is the last one. Can I leave this one?
You can skip through all the rest, and we're back into.
Yeah, we know we had two.
56 thing. Wow, we missed a lot of singing. There we go.
Thank you to the choir for leading us in all that. So we'll move on to our offering then. And if you spotted the offering plate on the table when you came in and left your envelope there, thank you. If you didn't, you can do that on your way out. And of course, you can always give by par or by e-transfer as well. Our offering is a sign of the confidence we share in the ministry we do together. Every act of faith, every act of giving is a response to God's invitation for us to do the work that God calls us to do. It's a sign also of our gratitude for all the blessings we've received and our heartfelt intent to pay forward those blessings. Let's pray. God, you invite us to prepare the way for peace.
Every act of faith and giving is our response to your invitation. May all that we offer of ourselves and our resources help to create peace in our time. Amen.
Before we turn to our prayers, I've got a few prayer requests. The first is, please pray for Jim Bidnell, who's still recovering from some surgery and had a difficult week. So, Jim, you're in our prayers. And Lisa Heinrich requests prayers for two young women that she knows who both have brain tumors, Megan and Tara. And one of those young ladies is Lisa's daughter-in-law. And she's having surgery later this month. So, our prayers go out to both of them. We continue in prayer for Jason and for Esco, and for Roberta's cousin John, who also had a very difficult week in his recovery from his transplant. And we pray for Sarah and for Catherine, who are both having a difficult time right now. Are there any other requests this morning? Kim?
Also for Lori, who's recovering from surgery, and for Joanne, who's taking care of him. And I'd ask you to keep John in mind as well.
For Lori, who's also had some surgery, and Joanne, who's caring for him, and also for John. Mark? Or, sorry, Kathy?
My sister Jane, who will be starting treatment again shortly.
For Jane, who will be starting treatment again. Sorry to hear that. Craig?
My friend Carrie, who has been in the hospital.
For Carrie, who's been in hospital.
Continue prayers for the Campbell family.
Prayers continue for the Campbell family. Kathy?
And continued prayers for the Grundy family who lost their house in the fire.
And yes, of course. Continued prayers for the Grundy family who lost their home in a fire in Morello. We take these prayers into the day and the week ahead of us. Let's pray. God of our Advent waiting, God of creation and beauty, we thank you for every blessing of this season, for gifts and giving, for joyful song, and for being together. We pray that our hearts might be filled with praise and that our lives will reflect your glory. Be with us, God, as we seek to prepare the way for the celebration of Jesus by sharing the hope, peace, joy, and love that he taught us. Holy One, we pray for all who are struggling during this Advent season, whether illness, loss, anxiety, loneliness, addiction, despair, or any of life's deep challenges. These are especially difficult during the Christmas season. God, bring strength for the days ahead, and may all who suffer know your presence in the support and care of those who love them. May your Holy Spirit bring comfort, healing, and peace. Help us, God, to remember that you are as near as our next breath, loving us and enfolding us in your care. Build within us a strong spirit of thanksgiving, so that our grateful hearts will be moved to acts of giving and compassion, and so every act of kindness will bring a measure of peace to our world. Loving God, as we await the birth of Jesus and the birth once again of hope, peace, joy, and love in our world, may your Spirit enfold us and show us the way to the manger. And now we pray in the words that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. As we continue our Advent journey together, go into the world with courage and with peace. Go into the world with a daring and tender love. And may the love of God, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each of us this day and every day. Amen.